Yes, welcome friends once again. My first session on block diagram algebra from module 2 for subject called control engineering for 7th semester mechanical students. So here in case of block diagram algebra for session 1, these are the contents: general representation of a feedback control system, how the feedback control system can be represented using a simple block diagram that we can study here. Next, how to obtain the transfer function of a block diagram which represents any control system. Next, how to reduce the block diagram. Some of the rules are there. So those rules are guiding how to reduction of block diagram algebra. Coming to the first bit, that is general representation of a feedback control system. Here first you should know what is block diagram. So here a block diagram of a control system is the pictorial representation which depicts the interrelationship that exists between the various components of the system and also the direction in which the signal flows. The block diagram once again consist of several unidirectional blocks in which the transfer function of that component is written. So here every block acts as an amplifier, which is also called as multiplier, summing points where two or more signals get added and subtracted, and which also consists of takeoff points, or which is also called as pickoff points, where the samples of signals are taken and fed back for comparison. So here a simple block diagram, how it will represents, that we can see using a block diagram. So the below figure shows a standard block diagram of a feedback control system with standard notations are shown. So here the RFS, that is called reference input, sorry, EFS, the error signal, and GFS is called transfer function of that particular block, and CFS is output. So once again, that signal from the output is fed back for comparison, that is HFS, which is the transfer function of feedback signal. And here the BFS is the feedback signal. So here the standard block diagram of feedback control system shown here, where RFS is command or reference variable, CFS is control variable or output, and GFS is transfer function of control element, and HFS is transfer function of feedback element, and EFS is error signal, and B of S is feedback signal. So here transfer function once again represents the relationship between the output signal of a control system and the input signal for possible input values. A block diagram is a visualization of control system which uses the blocks to represent the transfer function, and the arrows which represents the various input and output signals flowing from one point to another point. For any control system, there exists a reference input known as excitation or cause, which operates through a transfer operation, that is transfer function, to produce an effect of resultant control or output variable. So thus the cause and effect relationship between the related to each other through a transfer function. So here the transfer function means once again a system can be represented using once again the block diagram. The input here taken as X of S, and the output is taken as Y of S, and transfer function, that is G of S. For this linear time invariant system, the transfer function, that is G of S, is given by S output to the input, that is Y of S divided by X of S, where y of s is the Laplace transformation of output and x of s is the Laplace transformation of input. So in Laplace transformation, if the input is represented by r of s, output is represented by c of s, then the transfer function is given by, once again, y of s divided by x of s. That is the transfer function of system multiplied by input function gives the output function of the system. So here, once again, what is transfer function? Transfer function of control system is defined as the ratio of Laplace transformation of the output variable to the Laplace transformation of the input variable, assuming all initial condition to be zero. So here some brief procedure is given how to get the transfer function of a control system as follows. First one, we form the equation for the system. Now you can take Laplace transformation of the system equation assuming initial condition to be zero and specify the system output and input. Lastly, we take the ratio of Laplace transformation of output to the Laplace transformation of input, which is required or known as transfer function. It is not necessary that output and input of control system are of the same category. For example, in electric motors, the input is electrical signal, whereas the output is mechanical signal. Since electrical energy is required to rotate the motors, similarly, in an electric generator, the input is mechanical signal and the output is electrical signal, since the mechanical energy is required to produce the electricity in a generator. But for mathematical analysis of a system, all kinds of signals should be represented in a similar form. This is done by transforming all kinds of signals to their Laplace form. Also, the transfer function of a system represented by Laplace form by dividing output Laplace form function to the input Laplace function. Some of the methods are here how to get the transfer function. So block diagram method is one of them to get the transfer function. It is convenient to derive the complete transfer function for a complex control system. Therefore, the transfer function of each element of a control system is represented by the block diagram. The block diagram reduction techniques are applied to obtain the desired transfer function. Another method is to get the transfer function using signal flow graphs. The modified form of block diagram is a signal flow graph. Block diagram gives a pictorial representation of a control system, while the signal flow graph further shortens the representation of a control system by concentration of signal flowing from one point to another point in the control system. So here are some of the rules how to reduce the block diagram into canonical form and obtain the transfer function. So here rule for the block diagram algebra, nothing but the block diagram reduction methods. The first one is blocks in series, how to convert into single blocks. So here g1 and g2 are transfer function of two blocks. Input is R, output is C. How to combine those blocks? If the blocks are in series, you just multiply the transfer function, that is g1 and g2, and convert into a single block diagram which represents the transfer function of that particular signal with input and output. Second one is blocks in parallel, so with summing point. So with R is input, C is output, g1 is the forward path in one direction and g2 is also forward path in another direction. Both are in flowing the same direction with the sign, respective sign. If it is positive, it is positive, negative, it is negative. In this example, both are positive sign. So if both are in the same direction, the signals get added. So hence input is R, output is C, so g1 plus g2. Similarly, shifting the summing point. If you shift the summing point, how the things are changing? So here in this example, the summing point is in between g1 and g2 and some feedback signal from A with g3. Input is R, output is C. So equation you can write here, C equal to R into g1 plus A into g3 at summing point. These are getting added, which is multiplied by g2, that is to get the output C. So So once again you multiply r into g1 g2 plus a into g2 g3. So on equation number 1. Shifting summing point against the signal, that is in direction, that is reverse. So in between block you remove to the left side, how the things are changing. So here the same example you can take, shift this side, the block g1 is coming in between, so that you can divide with the is the upper block, that is g3 by g1. So once again input r, output c, and feedback signal is a. Therefore how to write the value of c? That is r into g1 plus g2 plus a into g1 and g2, that is into sign is there, not x sign. So comparing once again equation 1 and 2, c equal to r into g1 g2 plus a into g2 g3, you can call equation 1 c dash r into g1 g2 plus a into g1 g2. So comparing equation 1 and 2, to get the value of s, that is taken as x here in this example. That is x nothing but, what is that? G3 by G1. So instead of G3 by G1, you written unknown variable x. So get that one. So once again, x equal to G3 by G1, while r into G1 G2 plus a G2 G3, that is equal to r g1 g2 plus a into g1 g3. Sorry, a into x into. So x is g3 by g1. So shifting summing point along the signal means ahead of the block once again. That is after g2. If it is in between g1 and g2, once again, write the value of c. C equal to r into g1 g2 because blocks in series plus a into, that is x, nothing but g2 g3. So comparing equation 1 and 3, so we have once again r into g1 g2 plus a into g2 g3, that is equal to r into g1 g2 plus a into x, where x is g2 g3. So one important point here, whenever a summing point is moved along the signal, then the transfer function of the block around which summing point is moved must be inserted. That you should keep in mind. Coming to the next rule, that is moving takeoff point. Similarly, how you shift the summing point, no? Similarly, you can move the takeoff point also. So here r is input, c is output, g1 g2 two blocks, in between b is there, that you can take g2. So here b equal to r into s g1 g3, r into g1 g3. Moving the takeoff point against the signal means left side, how the things are changing with the same example. R is input, C is output, G1, G2, those blocks in series. You can take here B dash X equal to G2, G3. So B dash equal to R into X. Comparing equation 4 and 5. So we have R into G1, G3 equal to R into X, where X is G1, G3. So one more important thing you note down here, what is that? Whenever takeoff point is moved against the signal, then product of transfer function of block diagram around which takeoff point is moved must be inserted. Next, moving the takeoff point along the signal means ahead of the block in the forward path. Same example, if you take, so R is input, C is output, G1, G2 blocks in series. The takeoff point is taken after the G2, where x is g2 by g3, that is b double dash. B double dash equal to r into x g1 g2. So x is here g2 by g3. So comparing equation both, once again 4 and 6, we have b equal to r into g1 g3. 6 is b double dash r into x into g2 g3. So comparing r into g2 g3 equal to r into x into g1 g2, where x is g2 by, sorry, g3 by g2. So one more point note down here, important point, that is whenever a takeoff point is moved, So once again here, whenever the takeoff point is moved along the signal, then reciprocal of the transfer function of the block around which takeoff point is moved must be inserted. So once again, merging of two summing points, if there is no block in between, so you can merge it. Input is R, output is C. One summing point signal is Y, another summing point signal is Z. So you can merge it. Input is R, output is C. Instead of two summing point, you can make only one. So one is Y signal, one is Z signal moving to the summing point. Coming to the rule number 6, feedback signal or standard canonical form. How to remove this feedback loop? As I discussed in the simple block diagram, R of S, E of S error signal, G of S is transfer function of our path, C of S is output, H of S is feedback signal path. So here, that is also called as closed loop transfer function or control ratio, that is output by input, nothing but C of S divided by R of S. That is equal to G of S divided by 1 plus or minus G of S into H of S. So here, if the feedback signal is minus, you should take plus here. If it is plus there, so take minus here. And feedback is positive, so in the numerator, 1 minus G of S into H of S. And the feedback is negative, that is, closed transfer function is G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So like this, you should know this, keeping in all these rules to solve the block diagram algebra. Or you can tell, reduce the block diagram into simple form to obtain the transfer function. This is my first session. Once again, the summary of my first session is, you have studied or discussed general representation of feedback control system with this simple block diagram. Then transfer function, what is transfer function, and how to get the transfer function using two methods. One is block diagram method, one is signal flow graph method. And some of the rules we have discussed. So how to decrease the block diagram into canonical form, nothing but simple form. That is blocks in series, blocks in parallel, shifting of summing point. When shifting of summing point against the signal, shifting of summing point along the signal. Then shifting of takeoff point. Once again, shifting of takeoff point against the signal. And shifting of summing point along the signal. Then merging of two summing points. And to remove the feedback signal. So with this, I will end my session. Thank you.